Sir Handel! Sir Handel! Wake up! Sir Handel! Sir Handel! Wake up! Sir Handel! Sir Handel! Wake up!
What is it, Peter Sam? Can't an engine have a rest before his next train?
But I have great news!
Well, it better be.
I heard from the Vink controller that we will have a special guest coming to our centenary to open our extension.
So?
That guest is the Duke!
Duke? Our Duke?
Yes, Grandpuff!
You must have heard wrong.
Nope, the Vink controller heard it from the owner, who heard it from Grandpuff himself.
Wow, after all these years, we'll finally see old Bulldog. I'll admit, that is worth waking me up.
I wish Duck was as excited as you, he keeps saying.
There are no Dukes. They were finally Staley, but they've all been scrapped. I'm sorry, Peter Sam, but that's just how it is.
Oh dear, this is dreadful. Duke is scrapped and Scarlowe and Nace's centenary will be ruined. Doc told me the Duke isn't coming. It's a shame.
I think that Duck is pulling your wheels.
He was quite serious.
He always jokes like that.
Since when?
That doesn't sound like Duck to joke like that.
Well, you haven't been around him as much as I have.
But to joke to Peter Sun like that.
That's rubbish.
What is all the noise about?
It's about Duck, sir. He said the Duke isn't coming tomorrow.
Nonsense. In fact, Scarlowe, there has been a change in tomorrow's work. I need you to meet the Duke at 11 instead of 10:30.
If there is a Duke. Listen, here's Scarlowe. They're cheering him.
Good. Perhaps that will make up for his disappointment over the Duke.
I've brought the Duke! I've brought the Duke!
The Duke? Where? I don't see him.
I can't believe he came! That's one in the headlamp for Duck.
Do you see him? Where is he? Reneus, who's that man riding on Scarlowe? And where is Duke?
The man riding Scarlowe is the Duke, Peter Sam.
But what? But he's not the Duke. He's not our Duke.
Ladies, gentlemen, and engines. I have the pleasure in declaring your lovely lakeside loop line open.
Excuse me, sir, Duke. Are you real?
Scarlowe said you've been listening to Duck. Duck thinks that Dukes were Great Western engines. But Dukes are really people. I am happy to assure you, Peter Sam, that I am a real-life Duke. I congratulate you, sir, on your remarkable record.
Oh, Duke.
You must be a record indeed.
Shush!
You have two locomotives in regular service, and both...
That speech the Duke gave was very nice, wasn't it, Scarlowe?
Certainly a treat, and I hope others get to visit our twins in Towen.
And I heard he was opening the castle up in Ulfstead.
Oh, that is exciting. What do you think, Peter Sam?
That's fine and all, but the real Duke never came.
Rubbish, of course he was real. You saw him.
All the same, he wasn't our Duke.
Our Duke was an engine.
Huh! You're as bad as he is. Old Gengen Dukes were scrapped. Ask Duck.
Duck doesn't know everything. Why don't you two tell us about him?
Well, it all started when I was new to the line.
Once upon a time, a little engine lived in his own little shed on his own little railway. That engine was Duke, named after His Grace, the Duke of Sodor himself. He was the first engine on this line, and wanted everything to be just so. Anything otherwise would never suit His Grace. And, you guessed it, I was that engine. Of course, there were those who weren't just so. There was our number two, Stanley, dare I say his name. And then, in 1904, our number three arrived.
Ah, Duke, there you are. This here is our engine number three. Now, as tradition, we'll name him after the company where he was built. Welcome to Sodor, Falcon.
Ah, pleased to meet you, Falcon. I hope you like it here. Now, Falcon was eager to start work. But he was a bouncy rider. Not as bad as Stanley, but all the same. Honestly, what is it with you new engines and your rough riding? You two spill minerals everywhere!
Regaged wheels, Dookie. I wasn't built for your dinky railroads, remember?
Railway, Stanley. Remember, you're not in America anymore.
Whatever. I have some cars to pull, if you don't mind.
Trucks! Trucks, Stanley, trucks!
I'm sorry, Duke. I try not to bounce. I feel so unbalanced.
I've seen you with trucks, Falcon. Seems to me that you do it on purpose. However, you do try your best with the coaches and passengers. Falcon did seem to care about his work, unlike Stanley. I grew fond of him. Some time passed, but it was about time to send Falcon back where he was built.
Stanley, the other engines are busy with their work, so I need you to shunt Falcon to the docks. He is to go back to England for repairs, and no rough riding. Both of you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I don't see what all the fuss is about. We don't care about a few spills in the States. If you ask me, old Dookie's nothing but an old fusspot and a real fuddy-duddy.
Duke isn't that old.
Ha! He's what, around 30? That seems old to me, kid. Old steamers like him are all just party poopers, thinking they can rule the rails because of their age. You know, I heard that the manager was thinking about you running the mountain road.
Really? I've heard it had an amazing view.
I know, but old Fusspot said that you weren't fit to run it. Said you are too bouncy.
What? But I could do it.
Like I said, thinking he rules the rails.
Vulcan was only gone for a short while, and when he got back, he was a less bouncy engine. I was impressed. Eventually, the manager came to see Vulcan.
I'm pleased with your work so far. Those pony trucks really improved your bouncing. Now you must learn the most difficult part of the line. The mountain road.
Yes, please, sir.
So tomorrow, you will go on it with the picnic. With Duke.
Duke?
Yes, Duke. He'll explain everything.
That old fusspot. It's not fair. I don't need Duke to show me the line. I'm perfectly stable and can handle the picnic on my own. He'll only block the view.
Just tell him you'll lead. Then that old fuddy-duddy will see you just as capable as he is. More capable, even.
Still, it is the difficult part of the line.
Difficult, smifficult. If you think you can handle it, then you can handle it. Am I right? Or am I right?
Yeah, you're right. I can handle it on my own, and I'll show the old fusspot.
I arrived at the station later that day, and got uncoupled so that I could lead with Vulcan. To my surprise, that wasn't his plan. Listen, the mountain road is difficult. You pull the picnic, and I'll lead.
No, I'll lead. How can I learn the line with you lumbering ahead and blocking the view?
Suit yourself. But never mind the view. Attend to the track.
Look at the track? What on earth for?
I probably should have been at the front, especially with that blocking the view bit from him. But he had been good. Better than Stanley, for that matter. I guess I just trusted him.
Wow, this is lovely.
Look at the track, Vulcan. Never mind the view.
Fusspot, fusspot. Funny duddy, funny duddy, funny duddy.
The mountain road did have a lovely view. However, it was very dangerous for an engine to take his eyes off the track, especially when coming out of tunnels or traveling too fast, which Vulcan disagreed.
Don't dawdle!
No hurry! Young ones, no patience. soon, we approached the tunnel by a workman's cottage. Now, this tunnel was curved and pitch black. You had to be very careful when coming out, as the line curved sharply to the right. Vulcan seemed a bit nervous.
I want to get out!
Watch the track! Watch the track!
How can I, you old fusspot? I'm too dazed to see them! Wow, that's a mayor! Whoa! Help! Help!
Quit whining, you young idiot! And stop shaking! I can't hold you if you shake! It wasn't long before my driver and fireman and the workmen from the cottage got to work on us.
There. We strengthened the coupling between you two.
Thank you. Now I can manage. Or so I thought. But not long after, I felt hot and uncomfortable. I began wheezing alarmingly.
Water! Duke needs water, quickly!
It was a good thing that cottage was there too. The workman ran up to his cottage and explained the situation to his wife. Then he and the passengers started passing anything that could hold water, hand by hand.
We're winning! Don't stop now!
All the while, Vulcan had calmed down. He must have accepted his fate.
Don't worry, Vulcan. We'll have you back on the rails in no time.
I promise. I was gaining more strength as my thirst was quenched. Everyone was working with a will. At last, we cheered when Jim brought the breakdown crew. With everyone's help, we were able to get Vulcan back onto the rails. He was still quiet, though. I promised we'd save you, didn't I? He stayed quiet for the rest of the journey. I didn't bother to tell him to look at the tracks this time. I think he learned his lesson.
Ladies and gentlemen, please accept my apologies for the accident. And I thank you all for your bravery and help.
Not at all.
Your Duke is a hero. He stood firm like a bulldog and wouldn't let go.
We admire the way you and your crew put things right.
And the adventure.
Vulcan and I made our way back down to Arlsberg to bring the passengers home. Vulcan finally decided to break his silence.
Hey, Duke.
Hmm? Yes, Vulcan?
Thank you for saving me. I don't know why you bothered after I've been so rude.
Ah, well, you just had a new coat of paint. It would have been a pity if you'd rolled down the mountain and spoiled it. That would never suit his grace, my friend.
That's the last time I listen to Stanley.
Stanley? What does he have to do with this? He explained the whole story to me all the way to the station, and I explained it to the manager. Neither of us were surprised. The next day, while Vulcan was being inspected for any damage, The manager spoke to Stanley.
Stanley, you have been causing a lot of trouble since you've come here, but yesterday was a whole different level. People could have gotten hurt, not to mention costing a lot of money with all of your rough handling with the trucks. This is your last warning, Stanley.
Stanley stayed silent. At least until the manager left.
A lot of nonsense about a few spills. In the States, a few spills is nothing to worry about. We don't care a dime.
We do here. Would you be laughing if the passengers fell down the cliff? Do the States care a dime about their passengers?
I don't see what that has to do with me. Falcon was the one who derailed.
Falcon had his doubts before you talked him into it.
The kid wanted advice, and I delivered.
There's a difference between good advice and bad advice, you know.
So it's bad advice to give someone some confidence in his abilities?
It's bad advice to not listen to those with experience in dangerous situations. You'll probably learn a thing or two from His Grace.
There is a thing or two I'll say about His Grace.
At this point, I'd rather not repeat what that imbecile said. Besides, he would have his comeuppance a few days later.
Okay, Stanley. This is a very important train, specially requested, so...
Yeah. No rough riding. The coupling looks like it could break. Maybe I should... Hey! Get back here! Oh no...
Was promised a speedy delivery. I mean, that was a fast delivery, of course.
Stanley! Stanley was towed to a shed away from ours. He was silent. Unfortunately for him, the manager wasn't.
I gave you one last chance, Stanley. That load cost us a fortune. And now,
Sir, I...
Stow it! You were off the rails due to your roughness, which I have repeatedly warned you about. Your driver told you about bumping the trucks loose. Well, since you like bouncing so much, how about I take away your wheels? I will make you useful at last.
A pumping engine?
That's what he said. My own wheels felt like they would fall off. I was so scared. At least it's better than being scrapped.
If you say so.
Should we tell Falcon?
No. I'd save it for when the time is right. With Stanley out of the way, there was room for a new engine. And Jerry happened to be the first to meet him.
Jerry, I have something for you to do, if you please. I need you to help the new engine onto the rails.
But sir, I need to get back up to Arsdale for my new engine. So you've arrived at Kronk by rail, and then come to our railway by traction engine?
I'm guessing it was short notice. Something about a green engine derailing further down the line, or something.
Next, it was Falcon's turn to meet him.
Who are you?
This is Stuart. He's a new engine from the Kerr Stuart & Co. Company in England. Stuart? This is Falcon. You two can chat, but I have a train to pull.
So when do I start work? What is there to do? Any special trains like tourist? Or, oh, a train with a name? That'll be really special.
Duke will probably like you. Never seen an engine so ready for work.
Who's Duke?
He is Duke. He'll be around to talk soon. We'll probably be talking about his grace again. I usually just tune him out.
He seems a pretty old engine.
The oldest. He was the first one here.
Look, Mom, there's Falcon in another engine. Who's that one?
I don't know. How about we find out from Grandpa? He would know.
Grandpa? Grand... Pa... Puff... Grandpuff!
Huh?
A nickname for Duke! Grandpuff!
How clever! He'll love that!
Hello there! I'm Duke. Named after His Grace, the Duke of Soul. And I presume you're this Stuart I've heard about.
Yes, sir, Grandpuff.
Excuse me, what was that I just heard?
Grandpuff, like Grandpa for an engine. Stuart thought it was a good nickname for you.
Humph! Ignorance.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's not that bad. I actually like it. You scallywags.
Grandpa.
Stuart proved to be a hard worker, tackling any job he was given. However, he was rather cheeky, and often picked on me. It wasn't long before Falcon followed suit.
Engines come!
And engines go!
But Grandpa goes on forever!
What cheek!
Oh, come on now, Duke.
We know you love us.
More like tough love. I was fond of them, but there is a time to laugh and a time to work. One day, I was pulling the picnic for the summer visitors. This was my special tray, where I would take passengers up the line, stopping anywhere they wanted. My driver and I knew all the best places for picnics. Please don't be late when I come back. We might miss the boat, and that would never do. I always pulled it, even if I felt bored. I mustn't disappoint my friends. That will never suit his grace. The morning run gave me no trouble. It was the end of that journey that left me feeling poorly, however. I was short of steam and glad of a rest before starting back.
Hello, Grandpuff. Are you short of puff?
Nothing of the sort. Routine maintenance, that's all.
Tell you what, Grandpuff, you're getting old. You need to take care. We'll have to keep it in order or one day you'll break down.
Humph! That'll be the day. You keep me in order. Impudence! But I couldn't stay cross for long. It was a beautiful evening. All the picnic parties were ready, the coaches ran well, and we lost no time anywhere. Couldn't be better! Couldn't be better! Soon we began to climb. It was hard work. I've plenty of steam. We'll be up in a couple of puffs. But it wasn't a couple of puffs. More like a couple of wheezes.
It's not so easy. My old fans would start blowing now. But I'll manage.
But my leaks became worse. At the next station, my driver looked all over me while the guard went to telephone for help. The passengers started to get anxious.
Is there anything we can do to help?
Will we miss our boats?
Don't worry, my friends. You won't miss the boat. I promise you that.
Two engines are coming. We should be away in 15 minutes. You'll easily catch your boat.
Surely my valves sound worse than they really are. I can continue.
No, Duke. Our passengers will be worried.
Yes, I suppose so.
Poor old Grandpa, what a shame you've broken down.
Oh, no.
This is the day.
Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
We stopped at the middle station. Falcon went on to the port with the picnic, while Stuart headed Falcon's train. With me coupled behind.
Fancy me rescuing Grandpa! This is the day! This is the day! This is the day! Poor Grandpa, he's much too old. We'll have to keep him in order now. Kindly but firmly.
As silly as Stuart sounded, he was amusing. I didn't know whether to call out his ignorance or to laugh at it. Besides, my driver and I had our own joke ready. We used just enough steam to keep moving. But at last, we reached the hill before the station.
Now.
Driver advanced my regulator, and I responded with a will.
Whoa, what the? What on earth was that, Duke?
Well, I figured you could use some help uphill.
Where are the two engines on this train, Mum? It's most unusual.
It is, but today was different. Stuart broke down.
What?
They had to call Duke out to help him. Duke had a hard job too, by the sound of it.
But I... Oh, for crying out loud.
poor old engine. It's no good, Stuart. You can't win. Stuart was still definitely a cheeky engine, even after that event. He and Falcon still made fun of me, though I knew it was out of kindness. They would never try to spite me. Still, I figured it would be wise if I taught them a lesson.
Engines come.
And engines go.
But Grandpuff goes on forever!
You impertinent scallywags. Whatever are young engines coming to nowadays?
Never mind, Grandpuff. We're only young once.
Well, you'd better mind. Unless you want to end up like number two.
What did happen to Stanley? I never hear talk of him anymore.
Oh, Grandpuff, whatever happened?
So I told Stuart the story of Stanley. How his rough riding and coming off the rails caused so much trouble, and how I had warned him multiple times to be careful. The latter was the only thing Falcon didn't know.
So what did the manager do?
He turned him into a pumping engine.
What?
He's still here, behind our shed.
And he's been quiet all this time?
Well, if it's made him grateful by now, I'm all fine with that. He could have been scrapped.
Serves you right.
Stuart and Falcon were unusually good for several days. And they became much more useful engines. We were happy for many years, sharing laughs and being there for the hard times. But then came even harder times that would change the railway forever. Huh. That doesn't sound like Lily's whistle. Or Lady's, for that matter.
No, but it sounds like my whistle. My name is Colin. I'm filling in for Lily whilst he helps out on the main line.
The main line? What's going on there?
Well, a big green engine decided to stay in a tunnel from the rain.
Oh, the impertinence. Is it that same green engine that derailed 3 years ago?
No, it was another green engine.
Hmm.
But besides that, the power company for Peel Godred decided to construct a branch line from Kildane.
Really? I thought they were going to use our line.
They were. But there were slim clearances on the mountains section of your line.
I don't like the sound of that. And I was right not to. The opening of that line negatively affected our railway. We started having less passenger and goods traffic. We still had summer visitors, but other times, the mountain road ran nearly empty. Soon, some of our engines and coaches had to be sold. Driver, weren't we supposed to take the picnic today?
Sorry, old boy. The coaches have been sold. Remember?
Oh, right. Atlas, what brings you here?
The mines are flooded, so I'm here to pick up Stanley to pump out the water.
Are you sure he'll be able to clear it out?
It's the only chance we have. I have to collect the truck for him.
Well, Stanley, well, you've been a real knucklehead in the past. To put it in kinder words, you have been a quiet engine these last few years. But if you have anything to say to me before you leave, you'd better say it now.
Yeah, I have something to say to you, Dookie. I'm sorry.
What was that?
I'm sorry for all the trouble I caused back then. After having to see you and Falcon and the others having fun with each other, I've learned that you aren't such a party pooper after all. Especially after that time with the little green one. You know, that last day I was an engine, it wasn't really my fault.
Go on.
The trucks I was pushing, they have some rusted up couplings. I was gonna stop, but they broke free before I could.
I derailed only because I was chasing after them.
Why didn't you tell the manager?
He wouldn't listen. Besides, even if I said anything, no one would have believed me. It's like Falcon said, I deserve this.
Maybe so. But engines also deserve forgiveness, if they really mean it. And I forgive you, Stanley.
Would you do me a favor? Can you tell Falcon that I'm sorry for causing him so much trouble as well? Even if he doesn't forgive me, at least he'll know.
I will, Stanley. I will.
Thanks, Grandpa.
I stayed strong for a while. I didn't want Stanley to see an old engine cry. He was soon moved to the mines. Atlas said it was the hardest he'd seen him work. Unfortunately, it wasn't enough. The mines couldn't be saved, and Stanley went down with it. Atlas was sold off too. To where, I know not. All that I know is that Stuart, Falcon, and I were all that was left. Before we knew it, our line closed, and people came to buy us. But by us, I mean...
You know what takes to win, Falcon?
What about Duke?
He's just a little too old.
Rubbish! He may be old, but he's just as useful as either of us.
Even more useful, it's all of us or none of us!
Lads, it's okay. I won't have you risk a new life just for my sake.
But, Grandpa...
No buts! I'll be fine. I promise.
Right then. Come with me to sign the papers.
Never mind, Grandpa. We'll find a nice railway and then you can come and keep us in order.
I looked at the two engines for the last time. Their hearts were in the right place, but I doubted it would ever happen. Eventually, they left. And my driver and fireman oiled and greased me one last time.
There you go, boy. Sheeted snugly. This should keep you protected.
Now be careful of vandals. They'll come in and break things. Don't scare them too much, Duke.
But where will you two go?
I'll have to find work, Duke. I'm sorry we can't stay.
We'll miss you, old sport. It was an honor working with you.
It's been a pleasure to be driven by you two. They said their goodbyes and left. Then there was just me, alone, locked up in the sheds. Where's his grace? It's not like him to forget me. Oh well, I'll just go to sleep then. It'll help pass the time. I can even tell myself stories. Now, where should I start? Once upon a time, three little engines lived in their own little shed on their own little railway. Now I'm just making myself sadder. Thanks a lot, Grandpa. Am I starting to sound like Stuart?
And that's the story of Duke.
I see now why you were so upset about the Duke. We're sorry, you two.
It's okay. We never believed we could see him again.
He was built by the Duke,
The father of the Duke now, I mean, and...
He warned him about riding roughly, but he wouldn't listen. But one day...
They were climbing the mountains, and Duke told Sir Falcon...
He arrived from Kronk, and they had to tow him by tractor, so they get to...
The station! And they saw a mother and her child going to see their grandfather, and... Get this. They decided to call him Grandpuff. How brilliant. And
with much noise, he pushed the train up the hill. Peter Sam said he caught him by surprise.
And they left him because they thought him too old.
So he's still out there?
Let's hope so. Ready to go on an engine hunt?
Our railway is laid on the bed of the old one, but swings round to end at the road south of that village. The old line kept straight on. It went north of the village and then to the mountains. The maps show the works at the old station. If Duke is anywhere...
He's there.
Are you writing another book, sir?
Yes, but not about you. Oh, cheer up. It's about a nice old engine who is lost. But if you're good, the artist might put you in the illustrations.
Oh, thank you, sir.
There were three old engines who used to work on your lines years ago. Stuart and Falcon are now on the Scarlowy Railway as Peter Sam and Sir Handel. But poor Duke was left alone.
Oh, that's terrible.
And we want to help find him, mend him, and make him happy once more. Your controller wants to help, but he can't if you're naughty.
We promise to be as good as gold, sirs. Hope you find him.
Any luck, sir? Oh, your clothes!
Nothing yet, Rex. Just scratches.
But we're not giving up. Duke's there. Somewhere.
I'm going over this hill to see if I can find any clues.
Okay, careful where you tread.
This is exciting. I feel so much like Sherlock Holmes, looking for clues, deducing the hidden engine. Maybe if I find him, I can say, it was elementary, my dear Audrey!
Kenny, are you alright?
Oh, I'm fine. I just... He's here. He's here! Our Sleeping Beauty himself!
Excuse me! You aren't a vandal, are you? Driver told me that vandals break in and smash things.
Heavens no. I'm quite respectable. I dropped in because I couldn't find your door. Stuart and Falcon will be pleased to see you again.
So they did remember. Does His Grace approve?
Yes, he's coming.
To see me? How kind! And I'm all dirty. Oh, that will never do. Please clean me.
No problem.
Well, I'll be. He is the most splendid engine I've ever seen.
Pardon me, but are you His Grace? You look different.
Oh, why, yes. Yes, I am. Sir Robert Normanby, the Duke of Sodor. The Duke, remember my father, had passed away during the war. He didn't tell me about you, Duke.
I see. I'm sorry for your loss, Your Grace.
Thank you, Duke. But now I have something special to remember him by.
What is this?
It's a low loader, Duke. We have to take you by road.
But I'd be ashamed to travel by road. It's undignified.
I'm sorry, Duke. But the small railway has no suitable tracks to take you. Don't worry. We'll soon take you by rails, on the Northwestern Railway to your new home.
Well, all right.
There he is!
Hello, Duke.
I'll be King Ori. I never thought I'd see engines smaller than me.
So this is the Duke that Peter Sam was talking about. I owe him an apology.
Peter Sam? Who's he?
He's talking about Stuart. He and Falcon have different names now. Stuart is Peter Sam, and Falcon is Sir Handel. Don't worry, you'll still recognize them.
He's there!
Shush! You woke me. In my young days, engines were...
Seen and not heard, Grandpuff. Remember?
Oh, I remember, all right. I remember two idle good-for-nothings called Falcon and Stuart.
Good for you, Grandpuff. We're glad you've come.
We've missed you, Baldark. We've never forgotten you.
I missed you both as well.
Since you're here last, we can keep you in order now.
Keep me in order? Impertinence! Be off!
Engines come and engines go.
But Grandpuff goes on forever. Impudent scallywags.
Duke, I have a question.
Ooh, well then, ask away, Falker, Sir Handel.
Well, didn't you have a brother? Whatever happened to him?
That is a good question. What did happen to Bertram?